Hey guys, what's up? While we wait for church to start, we're gonna play a game. So I'm gonna draw something while my eyes are closed and you have to guess what I'm drawing, okay? Ready? Here we go. What do you think I drew? That's not too bad. I was trying to draw a flower. If you guessed, you're right. All right, next thing. All right, so now I'm gonna draw something a little harder, okay? Here we go. Did you guess what I drew? I was trying to draw a tiger. If you could guess it, good job. Next picture. All right guys, so this one's gonna be the hardest out of all of them. Are you ready? Make sure you have your thinking caps on. Here we go. Guess what I drew? I was trying to draw church because it's time for church. Come on, let's go. All right, kids, let's see those smiling faces and those wavy arms because it's time for worship. Are you so excited? Me too. Okay, so before we start, I'm gonna start us off with a little prayer. I want you all to join me and to mean it from your heart, okay? Dear Lord, we thank you for bringing us together. We thank you for giving us the opportunity to still worship you. Lord, we pray that you keep our hearts pure and our minds clear as we worship you and give you our all today, God. We thank you, we praise you, and we give you all glory and honor. Amen. Let's go!
without touching the floor. Whoa! Okay, and then when I count to three, we're gonna jump up all together as high as you can. You guys ready? One, two, three.
What an awesome time of worship. What was your favorite song? Be sure to leave it down in the comments. Now let's go see what Tim and Tommy are up to.
Help, I need somebody.
Help,
not just anybody.
Help,
you know I need someone.
Help.
This is the way we wax our legs, wax our legs, wax our legs. Oh, wow. It's like I'm a hobbit or something. Hold on. Emergency help center, this is Tammy. What's your emergency? Slow down, I can't understand a word you're saying. What? Your hamster's dancing on your freezer? Oh, you're feeling sad. My bad. Okay, you need some help. Of course you do. We'll send someone right down. Timmy, Tommy, this is Tammy. We have an emergency.
This is Timmy, go ahead.
We have a woman who's down at 192 Electric Avenue.
This lady needs some help.
We're on it. Wake up!
Oh, cupcakes don't know how to skydive. What's going on, Timmy?
There's an emergency, Tommy. Somebody needs help.
Somebody needs help. Let's go.
Help. I need somebody. Help. Not just anybody. Help. You know I need someone.
Help. What's this emergency all about?
Well, Tammy said there was some lady sad and depressed. I think this is the house.
Excuse me, ma'am. We're from the Emergency Help Center. Do you need some help?
I sure do. I'm so sad. I just don't know what to do.
There, there. It's gonna be okay. And what has you so upset?
It's Uncle Nutty.
Oh, I am so sorry. Did something happen to your Uncle Nutty?
Well, yes. He got canceled.
He got canceled? You mean he died?
No, silly. I'm talking about my favorite TV show, Uncle Nutty's Wampadoo Jamboree.
Uncle Nutty's what a who what a re?
Uncle Nutty's Wampadoo Jamboree. It was my favorite variety show, and it got canceled after 37 seasons.
Okay, so I get it. You're sad because you'll never see the show again.
No. I actually own all 37 seasons on DVD. Oh, some of them are VHS, but I'm so sad.
Oh, that is sad.
But you know what to do when you're sad and depressed, right?
Write a fan letter to Uncle Nutty.
No, lady. Call on him.
Call on who?
Call on God. He hears you every time and he'll answer you.
What do you mean?
What he means is that all through the Bible, there have been people that have been sad and lonely and depressed. They'd lost their joy for all sorts of reasons.
But they called on God, and he gave them back their joy. He helped them with their sadness.
Wow. You really think God can do that for me?
Oh, man, I know he can. He always comes to our rescue when we call him.
Well, that's sure good to know. I'm gonna call on him right now and ask for his help.
That is an excellent idea, miss.
Emergency, emergency, we have a code 85.
Don't worry, Tammy, we'll take care of it for you. So remember, when you need help, just call. Let's roll.
Help, I need somebody. Help, not just anybody. Help, you know I need someone.
Hey guys, are you still awake? Cool. So for this game, you're gonna need a magazine or some kind of bendy book. And you're also gonna need a piece of trash. The goal is to hit the piece of trash with the book as many times as you can before the timer runs out, okay? Let's see if you can beat me. Ready? One, two, three, go!
What's up?
What's up?
What's up?
What's up?
Hi, yeah, it's me, Skittles, and I'm here to tell you what's up. Today we're talking about calling on God for help when you need joy. I'm so sad. So today, anytime somebody asks you what's up, you tell them, when I'm down, God will lift me up. It don't matter what's got you down. Maybe your doggy died, little bean puppy. Maybe you made a bad grade on a big old test. It don't matter what. I can promise you that God will lift you up and give you joy. So anytime, I mean anytime, somebody asks you what's up, you tell them, when I'm down, God will lift me up. And that's what's up. I got a rainbow of flavor, and I'm living for my Savior. Skittles out, baby.
Thanks, Ms. Praymore. Now it's time for today's Bible story. Have you ever heard of a guy in the Bible named David? Of course you have. We've been talking about him so much lately. He was the one who defeated the giant Goliath and got so much love and appreciation from all who were around him. But this wasn't all a good thing. You see, King Saul, who was king at the time, was very jealous that David was loved by all the people. He was so jealous that he even vowed to kill David. David had to run for his life. Can you imagine having to run from the king? The king had soldiers everywhere looking for David. David spent years of his life running from King Saul. he found a cave called Adullam. This is where David spent a lot of his time. He was supposed to be a hero, but instead he was a lonely man running for his life. One thing you need to know about David was that he was a songwriter. He actually wrote most of the book of Psalms that you find in the Bible. History tells us that when David was sat alone in the cave, he picked up his harp and began to write a song. You think maybe David would write a sad song. Maybe he would write a song about how bad his life is and how sad he feels. Maybe even a blues song. But he didn't. Most biblical scholars think that David wrote Psalm 34 while in the cave. It's a psalm of joy. I'm sure it wasn't easy for David to be full of joy when his life seemed so difficult, but God helped him have the joy he needed. In fact, we're going to learn a lot in our lesson today about how to find joy when we need it.
Teach you a rocking power verse. That's right, today's power verse says, let all who seek God's help live in joy. Psalm 69:32. Hey, that was an amazing power verse. And I need my girls to stand up and you're going to do the power verse with me, Wiggy. Are you ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Let all who seek God's help live in joy. Psalm 69:32. Oh, wonderful girls, you were amazing. Now sit down, sit down. I want all of my boys, that's right, my boys stands up with me, Wiggy, and you're gonna do a rocking power verse. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Let all who seek God's help live in joy. Psalm 69:32. Hey, well done, well done. Have a seat, have a seat. Hey, listen, boys and girls. Sometimes things in life make us very sad. Like the other day, I broke a string on my guitar. Yeah, like that. Well, I got very sad and depressed because I had a show that night and I thought there's no way I'm ever going to make it. Well, I realized my sadness and depression was not helping things. So I prayed, Lord, give me joy. I need joy. And you know what? Despite my broken string, despite the fact that I had to cancel that show, God gave me joy. And we ended up being able to play there another time. So it wasn't any good to be full of depression. Instead, I asked God to fill me with his joy. So, everybody, it's time for us to do the power verse together. Boys and girls, stands up. Here we go on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Let all who seek God's help live in joy. Psalm 69:32. Oh, nicely done, nicely done. Before you have a seat, let me hear your air guitar. Very good, very good. You may have a seat. Well, boys and girls, my name is Wiggy Pop, and I've got to go right now. But I'll see you next time when I teach you another rockin' power verse. We'll see you later.
It's okay, Gideon. It's time to start today's lesson. And I know that sometimes we can be sad. And sometimes we're so sad that we just can't shake it off. And that's called being depressed. And when we're depressed, we feel weird sometimes. Yes, we feel so weird. And we think we're the only ones that feel that way. But guess what? Guess what? We're not alone. The truth is that many people today suffer from sadness and depression. especially with everything going on right now. Today we learn from King David that even after killing the giant, he was still sad, and he found himself running for his life from King Saul. For years he had to hide in a cave and even act insane to stay alive. Can you imagine how sad it must have been to be in that cave all alone? Just as our Bible story taught us today, King David chose to handle this sadness in a very important way. He wrote Psalm 34 during that time. We can learn very important lessons from David as to exactly how to handle sadness by studying Psalms 34. Let's take a look. A lot of times we're embarrassed when we are sad. We hide the fact that we're depressed by putting on a fake smile. But David didn't do that. He knew that it was okay to feel sad. It's okay to cry. David wrote in his Psalm 34:6, "I cried out to the Lord in my suffering." Does that sound like he was hiding the fact that he was sad? Not at all. When we're sad, we don't need to hide our sadness and act like everything's okay. Sometimes you may feel like crying. Don't hold it in. Let it out. Feel free to cry and be honest about your feelings. David was. He was suffering and sad, and he admitted his feelings. He wasn't ashamed to cry. Remember, he cried out to the Lord. It's important to recognize who he cried to. The Lord. Why? Because God was there with him. When you're sad, it's important to remember, you are not alone. David says in Psalm 34:18, "The Lord is close to the brokenhearted." When you are sad, it's easy to feel you are facing depression all alone. But you aren't. God is close to you at all times, especially when you're sad. He is always there to help you. And all you have to do is call on him for help, because God hears you when you call for help. David remembered what we need to remember. He wrote about it in Psalm 34:17. The Lord hears his people when they call to him for help. When you are sad and depressed, call to God for help. He hears you every time. God is always in range, and he's never busy when you call on him. He answers. Isn't that awesome? When you call on God, he hears you and he will give you the joy that you need. David wrote in Psalm 34:5, "Those who look to him will be radiant with joy." When you are sad and depressed, God will give you the joy and the strength that you need to make it through sad times. Depression doesn't have to last forever. Call on God for help and let him fill you with his joy. Today, you may be feeling sad or depressed. You may have loved ones who are getting sick, or you may be sad that you can't see your friends anymore. And that's okay, but we need to remember who to call on when we need joy in our lives. So as we end our time together, let's pray for happiness and joy as we go through this rough time. Lord, we just come to you today, and we thank you for allowing us to worship in your presence today, Lord. God, we just ask that you bring your joy and you fill us up today, Lord. Many of us are sad and feeling depressed today, Lord, especially with these hard times that we're all going through. We're sad that we can't be as connected to the people that we love, Lord. But we pray that you come down and you fill us with happiness and joy, and that you can make our lives happy and full of wonder today, Lord. Jesus, we pray for all those who are sick, that you'll make them better. And Lord, we pray that you put a smiling face on each person who gets to see this and who gets to hear about your word. In your name we pray, amen. Thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to tune in next week to see what else we can call on God for help for. Bye-bye.